Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to talk about lipid classification and fatty acid. So what is lipid? Well friends, lipids, they are the heterogeneous group of organic molecules including fat, oils, steroids and related compounds which are relatively insoluble in water and soluble in organic solvents such as ether and chloroform. So classification of lipids can be done in the following ways: the simple lipid, complex or compound lipids, precursors and derived lipids. Okay, what are simple lipids? Simple lipids are the esters of fatty acids with various alcohols. So fat and oils, esters of fatty acid with glycerol. Oil is liquid while fat is solid at room temperature. You can see this structure here. Again, there are waxes, esters of fatty acid, usually long chain with alcohols other than glycerol. Example, you can see styl alcohol. So another one is complex lipids, esters of fatty acids with alcohol containing additional groups such as phosphate, nitrogenous base, carbohydrates and protein. So the most important complex lipid is phospholipid. Okay, this is very important. Short question can be asked to describe about the phospholipid and its importance. So lipids containing, in addition to fatty acids and alcohol, of phosphoric acid residue is there, usually have nitrogen containing bases and other substitutes. So look here, this one is glycerophospholipids. The alcohol is glycerol. Example, lecithin, cephaline and another one is sphingophospholipids. The alcohol is sphingosine. Example, sphingomyelin. So another one is glycolipids, that is glycosphingolipids, lipids containing a fatty acid, sphingosine and carbohydrate. Example, cerebrosides, ganglioside. Another one is complex lipids, lipids such as sulfolipids, lipopolysaccharides, aminolipids, lipoproteins. So precursors and derived lipids. So this includes fatty acids, glycerol, steroids, other alcohol, fatty aldehydes and ketone bodies, hydrocarbons, vitamins and hormones, acylglycerols, glycerides, you can see cholesterol and polystyrene. Esters are uncharged, so they are termed as neutral lipids. Now what are the functions of lipids? So this is the very important. From here you will be asked the questions. So function of lipids are concentrated fuel reserve of the body, triglycerol. Okay, by beta oxidation of fatty acids we can get high amount of energy. So constituents of membrane structure and regulates the membrane permeability, phospholipids and cholesterol. So these two compound has a very important role in maintaining the membrane permeability, fluidity of membrane. So what is the function of phospholipids and cholesterol in maintaining the fluid mosaic model or fluidity of the membrane? That can be a good question. So protect the internal organs, serve as insulating materials and give seven smooth appearance to the body. Fats are essential for absorption of fat soluble vitamins. They are important as cellular metabolic regulators, steroids, hormones and prostaglandins. So remember the term hormone, very important. So lipoproteins, these are the complex of lipids and proteins involved in transport of lipids in blood and are also component of cell membrane. So when you draw this structure of fluid mosaic model, you have to show lipoproteins. Now another one, fats serve as surfactants by reducing surface tension. Lipids present in myelinated nerves act as an insulator for propagation of depolarization wave. So myelinated neuron, you have already learned about that. So a knowledge of lipid biochemistry is important in understanding many current biomedical areas of interest. Example, obesity, atherosclerosis, myocardial infarction, role of various polyunsaturated fatty acids in nutrition and health. So for a marine animal to remain at given depth without constant swimming effort, it must have the same density as the surrounding water. And the one, the sperm whale undergo changes in buoyancy to match the density of its surroundings. This is possible due to the stored simple lipids in spermaceti organ. So the stored lipid is liquid at normal resting body temperature of the whale, about 37 degrees Celsius, but It begins to crystallize at about 13 degrees Celsius and becomes solid when the temperature drops several more degrees. The sperm whale undergoes changes in the buoyancy to match the density of its surrounding, from the tropical ocean surface to greater depth where the water is much colder, and thus defense. So what are fatty acids? So these are carboxylic acids with hydrocarbon side chain. It means they are the carboxylic acid. This is the carboxylic part. So butyric acid. So this is a butyric acid, the simple form of lipids. This one mainly occurs in the esterified forms as a major constituents of various lipids. May also present as free unesterified fatty acids. Fatty acids of animals' origins are much simpler in structure in contrast to that of plant origin. So remember the point that fatty acids will be activated in the cytoplasm, and then they are transported by current in shuttle in the matrix of mitochondria, where beta oxidation proper takes place with the release of high amount of NADH, FADH2 and acetyl coenzyme that again enters in electron transport chain to give many ATP. So mostly occurring in natural lipids are of even carbon. So biosynthesis of fatty acids mainly occur with sequential addition of two carbon. So addition of two carbon. Example, palmitic acid 16 carbon and stearic acid 18 carbon ORT. So ORT carbon number containing fatty acids are propionic acid 3 carbon and valeric acid 5 carbon. So what are saturated fatty acids? Do not contain double bond. Unsaturated fatty acid contain one or more double bonds. So they are monounsaturated, polyunsaturated. Mono means one double bond. Example, palmitoic acid. Polyunsaturated means one or more double bonds. Linoleic acid. Eicosanoates. This compound derived from eicosapolinoic fatty acids comprise the prostaglandins, thromboxanes, leukotrienes, and lipoxene. So short chain means they have less than 6 carbon. Medium chain means they have 6 to 14 carbons. Long chain means they have 16 to 24 carbons. So nomenclature of fatty acids. Naming is based on hydrocarbon from which it is derived. Saturated fatty acid end with suffix enoic. Unsaturated fatty acid end with suffix enoic. Numbering of carbon atoms from the carbon as 1 and the carbon adjacent to these are 2, 3, 4 and so on, or alternatively alpha, beta, gamma and so on. Terminal carbon containing methyl group is known as omega carbon. So this is the process by which nomenclature is done. So shorthand representation of fatty acids means total number of carbon atoms are written first, followed by number of double bonds, and finally the position of double bond starting from the carbonyl end. So this is the process by which the name is given to the fatty acids. So in exam you will be asked to calculate the number of ATP that you can obtain from complete hydrolysis of oleic acid. So this is another naming system involving omega. This is the omega, okay, symbol of omega. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbon number. You have to calculate like this. You have to go like this. So essential fatty acids. Fatty acids that cannot be synthesized by the body and therefore should be supplied are called essential. Chemically, they are polyunsaturated fatty acids, namely linoleic acid, linolenic acid, arachidonic. Now, arachidonic acid becomes essential if it is precursor. Linoleic acid is not provided in the diet in sufficient amount. So, this you have to note this. Biochemical basis for essentiality is the humans lack the enzymes that can introduce double bond beyond 9 to 10. So cis and trans isomerism of unsaturated fatty acids. So there are two isomerism, cis and trans unsaturated fatty acids. exhibit geometric isomerism depending on the orientation of the group around the double bond axis as cis form and trans form. So you can see the cis form of oleic acid and trans form oleic acid. Now functions of essential fatty acid: maintain membrane structure and function, transport of cholesterol, formation of lipoproteins, prevention of fatty liver, synthesis of eicosanoids. Deficiency of essential fatty acid results in pyoderma or toad skin. So some of the saturated fatty acids you can see here. So some of the unsaturated fatty acids you can see here. Please calculate the number of ATP that you can obtain by complete hydrolysis of oleic acid. That can be asked in your examination. So this much for today. Thank you. Bye bye.